So this fixity at E will have a reaction here, will have a reaction here. So this reaction will take care of sway. So therefore this problem is a non-sway problem. Right? So for this non-sway problem, let me calculate first what is the decay value. So the decay here is 2. The decay here is 2. So which is, you have theta B and theta C. You have a rotation at B. You have rotation at C. So rotation at B is, let me have coordinate number 1. Rotation at C, let me take coordinate number 2. So it is again 2 degree freedom system. So let us start with calculating the stiffness matrix. First column, give unit displacement at coordinate 1 and find the forces. To do that, I'll just draw the figure to you. Coordinate number 1 is at B, right? This is at B. Coordinate 1 is at B. You have fixed at A, D, and E, right? So when I have a coordinate at B, right? The members connected at B are BA and BC. So those members will try rotating in clockwise direction. This is clockwise. This is clockwise. Right? So this displacement, I will take it as 1, and this displacement, I will take it as 1. Now, what are the forces now? The forces will be, this side, it will be 4EI by L in clockwise direction, and this side it will be 4EI by L in clockwise direction. 4EI by L. Therefore, what is K11 now? K11 is force at 1 due to unit displacement at 1. Where is 1? 1 is at B. So therefore, you have forces, two forces, 4EI by L for BC and 4EI by L for AB. So therefore it is 4EI by L for AB member plus 4EI by L for BC member, right? Now substitute the values very carefully. What is E, what is I for that member and length for that member? 4E into I for member AB is I, and length for AB member is 6 meter. Length for AB member is 6. This plus 4E and I for member BC is I, and length for BC is 6 meter again. 6. And if you calculate this, you will get it as 1.33 EI. So this is K11. Similarly, K21 is force at B, force at 2 due to unit displacement at 1. What is force at 2? This is unit displacement at 1 figure. Force at 2 is, 2 is at C. Coordinate number 2 is at C. So calculate the forces at C. So the force at C, when you have 4EI by L at B, you have 4EI by L at this. So here it will be 2EI by L. This will be 2EI by L. Clear? Now, therefore, you have only, but CE and CD members are not connected to B. Therefore, they don't deflect. So hence, you have only one force at C, right? At C, which is 2EI by L, which is 2EI by L. So this is 2EI by L for member, 2EI by L for member BC. So 2 EI by L for member, substitute 2 EI by L for member BC. 2 E into I for member BC is I, and length for member BC is 6. So if you calculate this, it will be 1 by 3, so which is 0.33 EI. So this is K21. So this is first column, K11 and K21. Similarly, the second column, how to get the second column? Give unit displacement at 2, unit displacement at 2, and find forces at 1 and 2. Find forces at 1 and 2. How to do that? I'll just draw the figure for this. You have this. This is fixed. This is fixed. The coordinate number 2 is at C. Right? That is equivalent to theta C. Now, this is C. This is B. This is A, D, and E. Now, at C, very importantly, for the frame, you have three members connected. CB is one member, C is another member, CD is another member. All these members will try rotating in clockwise direction if I apply a couple at C. So our couple at C is clockwise. Therefore, you have rotation of C in clockwise direction, rotation of CD in clockwise direction, rotation of CB in clockwise direction. So all these displacement, I will take it as 1. So this displacement is 1, right? Now, what are the forces developed now? The forces developed will be where you apply here. It is 4 EI by L. Here, this 4 EI by L. And here it is 4 EI by L. Now, other side, it will be 2 EI by L. But I am interested, our coordinate is at B. Therefore, at B, I have half of this 4 EI by L, half of this is here. It is 2 EI by L. 2 EI by L. Clear? So these are the various forces induced. Now calculate. K, first column, first element. The second column, first element is K21. K12. What is K12? Force at 1 due to unit displacement at 2. What is force at 1? 1 is coordinate number 1 is at B. So our coordinate 1 at B is, this is the force. So 2 EI by L is the force, right? This 2 EI by L is for member BC. Substitute, you will get it as 2 EI is I, L is 6. Again, you will get it as 0.33 EI, 1.3. That is 0.33 I. So this is also equals to K21. Clear? Similarly, K22 is the force at 2 due to unit displacement at 2. What is force at 2? Where is 2? 2 is at C. Coordinate number 2 is at C. Our coordinate number 2 is at C. So what are the forces at C? You have three forces. 4 EI by L for member CE. 4 EI by L for member CD. 4 EI by L for member CB. Right? So 4 EI by L for member CB plus 4 EI by L for member CD and 4 EI by L for member CE. So you have three forces. Substitute 4E into I for member CB is I and L for member CB is 6. This is 1. And 4E and I for member CD. Very careful. CD is I only. I divided by length of CD is 6. Plus 4E into I for member CE is 2I. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इट इज 2i डिवाइडेड बाय लेंथ इज 12 मीटर्स, राइट? एंड इफ यू कैलकुलेट दिस यू विल गेट इट एज के टू टू एज 2 ei. दिस इज 2 ei. So you, this is the second column. Therefore, your K matrix now is matrix K is first column 1.33, 0.33, second column 0.33, and 2. This is EI. This is the K value. Nextly, calculate the locking forces. Locking forces. So calculate fixed end moments. How do you calculate fixed end moments? Fixed end moments for this is you have member AB, load on member AB is you have load on member BC, and you have load on member CE also, and you have, you don't have any load on CD. You have a load UDL here, you have point load here, and you have UDL here. What are the forces now? See, this load, this is loaded in this in horizontal direction. So this is anti-clockwise, this is clockwise. This is loaded vertically downwards, so this is anti-clockwise, this is clockwise. Similarly, this is anti-clockwise, this is clockwise. So calculate this. This is equation, this is A, this is B, this is C, this is D, and this is E. So what are the fixed end moments? M, A, B, calculate that. M, F, A, B is equal to, it is minus WL square by 12. You will get the value in kilonewton meter, right? MF BA will be plus WL square by 12. We'll get it in kilonewton meter. MF BC is concentric load only. So it is W minus WL by 8. Kilonewton meter, and MFCB is plus WL by 8. You'll get kilonewton meter value, some value. I'm not going to give you these values. You calculate directly. I will give you the force value. So what is the force now? The force is P dash is equal to, at coordinate number 1, what is at coordinate number 1? At coordinate number 1 is at B, you have one clockwise, another anticlockwise, right? MF BA and BC. So this is MF BA is clockwise, MF BA and anticlockwise, MF BC. You'll get this. And at coordinate number 2 is at C here, right? You have only two forces. Supposing if you have any load here, then you will have the fixed end moments. So you'll have three forces there. So now right now it is only two forces, CB and CE. MFCB is clockwise, CE is anticlockwise. MFCB clockwise, and MFCE is anticlockwise. MF CE, right? And if you calculate this, you will get it as minus 60 and minus 150. These are the values. Okay, this is P dash. Nextly, P forces, there is no external force here, so P force is zero. External force, no external force. No external forces on the along the coordinate number 1 and coordinate number 2. That means there are no couple. Coordinate 1, 2 are rotation. Therefore, corresponding to these rotation, you do not have any external force couple at B nor at C. So therefore, P is 0. Then your equation will be, when P is 0, your equation for unknown displacement. Now calculate the unknown displacement. Unknown displacements are delta is equal to minus of k in, I will write the equation first, k inverse into p minus p dash. When p is 0, right, your delta will be equal to minus of k inverse into p dash, right? So you have 2 by 2 matrix of this, 1 by ei minus ei, ei inverse is 1 by ei, and k value is 1.33 0.33 0.33 and 2, that into minus 60 and minus 120, no sorry, minus 150, minus 150, right? And how do you do this? So minus 1 by ei into, change the principal diagonal elements, this is 2, this is 1.33, change the sign of other two elements, so this is minus 0.33, minus 0.33, multiply by the p dash value, minus 60, minus 150, and if you solve this, that divided by the determinant is 1.33 into 2 minus 0.33 square. And if you do this calculation, you will get it as 27.6 and 70.3 into 1 by EI. Right? Therefore, this is delta 1 and this is delta 2. So what are these delta 1 and delta 2? You have delta EI delta 1. EI delta 1, take this ei to this side, so ei delta 1 is corresponding to ei theta b, which will be 27.6, and ei delta 2 is corresponding to ei theta c, which will be 70.3. both positive get, so therefore this is clockwise. After this, you just calculate the final moments. How do you do this? Final moments. Apply the slope deflection equations, you will get the final moments. I will just write one value. So MAB is equal to MFAB plus 2EI over L into bracket 2 theta A plus theta B minus 3 delta over L. While writing this, you have some values 0. What are those values? You have theta A 0 because it is fixed, right? Theta D 0 because it is also fixed. Theta E 0, which is also fixed, right? And delta E is also 0 because there is no sinking of support. Clear? So therefore, others are theta B and theta C, which you have already calculated. So calculate this, substitute MFAB, 2EI URL, all this, if you calculate, you'll get minus 20.8 kilonewton meter. So this is MAB, and MBA, you'll get it as 48.3 kilonewton meter. MBC, you'll get minus 48.3. MCB, you will get it as 146.2. MCD, you get 46.9. MDC, you will get it as 23.48. MCE, you will get it as minus 193.0. And MEC will be 263.5. these are the final movements in kilonewton meter. How do you check these values are correct? What you can do is add all the forces along for joint C. That is, at joint C, we have MCB, MCCD, and MCE. If you add this, it should be zero. That means the movement at the joint C is balanced. And even at joint B, MBC and MBA, if you add these, you will get it zero. So that is the check whether the problem is correct or wrong. So this completes the problem.